about type when you said that the Proud Boys would stand back and stand by?
I don't know who the Proud Boys are. I mean, you'll have to give me a definition because I really don't know who they are. I can only say they have to stand down, let law enforcement do their work. Law enforcement will do the work more and more. As people see how bad this radical liberal Democrat movement is and how weak, the law enforcement's going to come back stronger and stronger. But again, I don't know who Proud Boys are, but whoever they are, they have to stand down, let law enforcement do their work.
Kaitlan, the president can say he doesn't know who the Proud Boys are, but the fact of the matter is that that's eerily similar to exactly what he says when he's been presented with something that he does want to answer to in the past. It seems his way of getting out of having to answer it or inoculate himself from having to take a stance. I mean, just remember back to 2016 when CNN's Jake Tapper asked him very specifically if he will denounce David Duke, if he wants David Duke support, and he says, I don't know who David Duke is. He seems to be taking a very similar, same tactic here. There's no chance, Kaitlan, that the aides inside the White House don't have that answer for him, who the Proud Boys are, and can't give him more detail had he wanted to hear it.
Also, look at the context in which this was brought up last night. It was when Chris Wallace was asking the president to denounce these white supremacist groups. He was making very clear in what realm he was referencing the Proud Boys, because then you saw Chris Wallace giving the president that opportunity, and the president said, I will denounce them, but he said, give me a name. What name do you want me to denounce? And that's when Joe Biden stepped in and said the Proud Boys. The president repeated the name, the Proud Boys. So it is very clear, if you were using context clues, what this group was, if the president is maintaining the story that he has no idea who this group is. He knew what it was, but instead of taking that chance to say, okay, I denounce them, the president instead gave them this new tagline that they have been celebrating today, the stand by, stand down and stand by, basically saying this suggestion of to be at the ready. Certainly that's the way they took it. So of course you've got to look at the context here of what it was brought up, how the group reacted to it. They certainly didn't take it as any kind of denouncement from the president, but now he is trying to clean up those remarks several hours later after we got a lot of blowback from some of his usual allies.
Well, let's see if the damage is done, if this clears anything up for anyone who cares and should, really, in the president's stance on this. Kaitlan, thanks so much. Kaitlan's at the White House for us. All right, let's talk about this now with CNN's Sarah Seidner, who has done in-depth reporting on the Proud Boys and groups like it. And also joining us is Rashad Robinson. He's the president of Color of Change. Sarah, the president says he doesn't know who the Proud Boys are. Why don't you help inform him?
Okay, I shall. And it's interesting that if he doesn't know who a group is, then why is he repeating their name and then giving them what they saw as an order or a rallying cry to stand back and, you know, and stand by? So, by the way, those words are now printed on shirts that they're selling. They are going to be using it as a recruiting tool. It makes them more well-known, and they're going to be trying to get more people into their group. Now, the group that the president is talking about in the debate, the Proud Boys, say that they are not white supremacists. They have people from all different racial backgrounds that are members of this group. However, they have certainly been involved in what one judge called political violence and an intimidation. And there is a case in New York, where you are, in Manhattan in 2018, where there is video of them shown, you know, beating these anti-fascists, all dressed all in black, and the Proud Boys, something is thrown at them, and they come at them, and there are, you know, a bunch of them kicking, beating, and two of them were convicted for attempted assault. This is the video there that the police put out looking at what happened there. You see there's one person in the red hat. And so the Proud Boys, just a melee there, and two of them were convicted of this. And you see them over and over again. What they usually do is they show up, they have a rally saying it's about free speech or about, you know, their own anti-fascism and against the far left. And they come completely armed to the teeth, with body armor on, and they say every time, this is only for defending ourselves. But that's not how New York saw it. They've also said they are not a hate group. They are suing over being called a hate group, but that's not how the agencies and organizations that track hate and that track hateful behavior see it. They've been studying them for a long time, and they are adamant. The ADL telling me today, this is a hate group, full stop, looking at all the things that they have done and said over time. Kate?
Rashad, well put and explained, Sarah. Rashad, the president as Kaitlan's reporting, the president seems to be trying to clean things up, if you will, as one says when they make a gaffe. I'm not sure this is a gaffe, though. Then I'd like your take on if you think he cleaned anything up.
I actually don't even know if he was trying to clean things up. It's, you know, it's a difference between actually trying to clean things up and maybe trying to move stuff under the couch or move stuff under a table so it's not as visible so everyone can move on. And in fact, we're not going to just move on because what we're dealing with here with this president has been years of giving space, of being in relationship, of being unwilling to condemn white nationalists from Charlottesville, from before he started his campaign, to even the years while he was on the Celebrity Apprentice going around the country with a racist conspiracy theory about President Obama. Nobody has any reason to believe this president that he does not know who the Proud Boys are and that he's not sympathetic at minimum to their causes and hasn't been enabled at every turn by social media platforms, by corporations who have looked the other way on the racism because they were getting tax cuts. So many folks are responsible for what we saw last night in terms of the president of the United States giving orders to a white nationalist group in the midst of a really contentious time in this country.
And if we're being real, we all can understand one thing as well. Getting back to, I don't know who the Proud Boys are. The president claims quite often to know everything about things that he doesn't know anything about, which would be just like widespread voter fraud, which has not materialized since 2016 when he claimed it did. It has not materialized now. He continues to say that, believe me, I know a lot about it. So you'd think that he could know something about what he's talking about here. So you just cannot believe that talk. Go ahead, Sarah.
I mean, all he has to do is ask somebody. There are people, he's the president of these United States.
Yeah.
He has people to do the research for him if he doesn't want to put it into Google. But like literally, you can go look and you can go search. You can see their point of view. You can go on YouTube and you can also see the point of view of all of these organizations that track groups, far right groups like the Proud Boys. It is unconscionable that the president of the United States used the name of a group and now says, well, I don't know who they are. Find out. You're the president of the United States.
Take it a step further, Sarah, when he says, I always denounce any form of any of that, when he was pressed repeatedly on do you denounce white supremacy, when he was also saying, the first time he was asked, just to be very clear, he said, he was asked, white supremacists support you. Do you welcome that? And his immediate response was, I want law and order. And he had to be asked again about condemning white supremacy. And then he says that I always denounce any form of that. And I'm curious, as the president says that, what impact does that have on these groups?
It's huge, because what it is to them is, it is absolutely something that emboldens them. They see it as his approval of them and that he is with them. We have seen this over and over and over again. To me, the moment that happened last night during this debate, while millions of people are watching this, was another fine people on both sides moment. That is how everyone who has been impacted, for sure, by white supremacists and white supremacy saw it. When you watch that, it was another one of those moments where you don't want to feel shocked because you've heard some of this rhetoric before, but you know that this emboldens those who want to further the cause of white supremacy. And white supremacists, neo-Nazis, you name it, the KKK, they see this as an approval, not a tacit approval, but an explicit approval of what they're doing and what they believe. And they believe, the president believes what they believe.
And it wasn't just the statement that he made about the Proud Boys. It was also the statement towards the end around his supporters and as it relates to voter and voter suppression and voter intimidation, which there is sort of nothing more sort of connected to the history of black people and our ability to express our will through the vote. Is to also at the other end be suppressed, being attacked on the vote. You know, there's a Facebook post right now that I've had direct conversation with leadership at Facebook up until 2 hours before the debate last night. We're trying to get them to pull down this post from Donald Trump Jr. calling on to enlist an army of Trump supporters to go to the polls. We watched the looters and shooters post that landed on Facebook in the height of the George Floyd uprisings. You know, we have watched this president stoke sort of his supporters, white nationalist groups, giving them sort of the permission to rally and to mobilize and to leverage social media platforms that use targeted marketing, that use radicalization, that use all sorts of tools to sort of bring people in. Yes, this president is responsible for so much of the hate that is happening in our society, but he is not acting alone. He has been enabled by so many that have put their profits above the sort of safety and the security and integrity of either systems or our democracy in this country.